If you want to be successful in the show ring, follow Holstein Canada's recommendations on the basics of proper showmanship. Regardless of whether it's a club, provincial, or national competition, the time you spend showing is the culmination of numerous efforts made long before you enter the ring. Confident in your fitting and preparation labors, you now focus on displaying your animal to its best advantage with natural ease and without extreme effort. Showmanship is a complete package, the combination of a lot of little things. Good showmanship is an art and talent which can be cultivated and refined. Fundamental in showmanship is a good fitting halter which enhances the appearance of an animal's head. With a properly fitted halter, your hand or part of the hand is under the chain, but fingers are not through the ring. Approximately 3 loops, not a figure 8, in a short lead strap prove manageable in one hand. This prevents the hand and lead strap from being in the animal's eye. You can also easily reach back and set your animal's tail head and regain the loop. This shows a poor-fitting halter, which is also held incorrectly. The loops in the lead strap are held in a figure 8 shape. The loop of the 8 is in the animal's eye. This impedes the calf from leading properly. This lead strap is wrapped in a tight loop. It may even be taped together. This does not display the accepted use of the lead strap. This competitor has the hand on the point of the calf's shoulder to steady it. This competitor holds the calf's throat at the turn of the jaw, which gives a more dairy appearance to the animal. However, this is done only after all other faults have been corrected. This calf also displays good head carriage. Walking into the ring, walk smartly using your left hand to lead the heifer. You walk fluidly in unison with your well-trained animal. If holding the throat gives a more dairy appearance to the animal, it should be held when entering the ring. In showmanship classes, when the last calf is in the ring, turn around and start showing your calf. The left hand should always be used to lead the calf, never the right hand, unless an injury or accident prevents this. Ensure approximately 5 feet between you and the animal ahead. Also, allow approximately 5 feet between you and the ring boards so both you and the judge can maneuver easily. This allows the judge to view your animal from both sides. The first competitor is the ideal distance from the outside of the ring, about 5 feet. The second competitor stands too close to the boards for the judge to move around the calf to view it from the other side. This competitor is grandstanding by moving out of line and closer into the ring toward the judge. This is a serious fault. Unacceptable actions detract from showmanship. Firstly, this competitor's elbow is too high. Here, the calf is held inappropriately and its nose is in the air. This competitor has his pants tucked into his boot, as well as the lead strap through his belt loop. He leads with a straight, stiff arm. Obviously, he doesn't care about his appearance, which projects a no-care attitude. This contestant is crouching with the cell phone highly visible. With her t-shirt out and hat number upside down, this competitor sidesteps. Note the shavings under the calf's belly and that she has not been brushed off. Hay is hanging from the calf's mouth. The front feet of this calf are too close together. Occasionally, a calf will sag through its front end, especially behind the shoulders. Use your hard-soled shoes to gently touch the calf's foot. With the assistance of the right hand on the point of shoulder, the calf slightly raises the calf's foot and repositions it underneath its body. Just by adjusting the calf's weight, the entire front end will tighten up. When the judge motions for a stop to walk around the calf, ideally lead it into an attractive standing position. As the judge moves around your animal, go ahead one short step. This gives the appearance of a long-bodied calf. A calf's hind feet should be 4 to 8 inches apart. Competitors should know the best procedure to accomplish this. Never touch the rear feet. Always follow the judge's instructions. When pulled into line from the outside of the ring, walk smartly the same way you entered the ring. Upon reaching the lineup, turn and lead the calf into place, setting it up to advantage. Adjustments are made to the loin, crops, and tail setting as necessary. Use the halter to move the animal ahead or back if rear feet require repositioning. Maintain a uniform lineup with the front feet of the animals in line. Keep your animal alert and be aware of the judge's location at all times. The first calf in the lineup should have its left or outside hind leg back. The last calf should have its right or outside hind leg back. For all other placings, the feet, either the right leg back or the left leg back, should be solidly positioned to show the calf's least amount of faults. This will show off the calf to its very best advantage. Each competitor places his right hand on the calf's shoulder as the judge walks down the front of the lineup. Competitors move fluidly to the side to give the judge a front-end view of the animal. The calf's nose slightly follows the judge. After the judge has moved by and has observed the front end of your animal, you should hold the throat if needed. If the judge takes one last look back down the lineup, he expects to see a nice lineup of front ends. If you are asked by the judge or you must correct how your animal is standing, the following procedure is advised. Take the halter in the left hand, walk forward, continue clockwise around the calf, and back through the hole. Go around the calf and, upon reaching the lineup, turn and walk backward as you lead it into position. Calves in line should move to make room for your animal if needed. An alternate permissible method of changing position, if easily managed, is backing your animal out of line. This should be practiced at home. When asked by the judge to move out of the line at the top of the class so he can get a better look at the animal, lead the calf walking forward. When coming into view of the judge, turn and walk backward while the judge is looking until he indicates for you to move on. You could be requested to lead counterclockwise off the top of the line in confirmation or showmanship classes. If this happens, walk backward with the left hand holding the halter. The right hand should be used to hold the throat if needed, or placed on the point of shoulder to steady the calf. Once again, if asked to move ahead by the judge, pass briskly on the inside of the ring. When motioned, turn forward and walk quickly back to line. This is not common practice, but you could be asked to switch calves in a very competitive class. This would be a championship class where it is very close among competitors. This process should not delay the show. A few calves, maximum four, will be directed by the judge to form a straight head-to-tail lineup. The ring steward will come and hold the fourth place animal, while the fourth competitor moves to take the third calf. The third competitor moves and takes the second calf. The second competitor moves and takes the first calf. The first competitor moves on the outside and circles behind to take the fourth calf from the ring steward. This allows each competitor to quickly analyze the animal he is going to lead. Practice showing your calf at home on a regular basis. Train your calf to react smoothly to your commands. Know your animal's faults and how to correct them quickly before entering the ring. Be natural and perform functions fluidly, not robotic-like. Showmanship is a complete package, the combination of a lot of little things. Good competitors use common sense. Practice makes perfect. Use every class as a learning experience. Good luck.